5 board meeting to order. Allison?
Banks?
Here.
Cervantes?
Here.
Glassfish?
Here.
Lyon?
Yes.
Pickrell?
Here.
Shirkey?
Here.
Statham?
We can all stand for a moment of silence and pledge allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Okay, folks, due to some scheduling challenges, we are going to change the order of the agenda real quick. Instead of our usual recognition of visitors at this time, we are actually going to have a presentation from Ron Hilton, the auditor for the district. There's another session that he has to get to the same evening. So, Ron.
Thank you. I appreciate you making that change for me. We have completed the audit of the financial statements of the district as of June 30th, 2017. We're working on completing the federal audit piece or the single audit, and we should have that done here in the next 2 weeks. During the audit, we had no findings or deficiencies in internal controls that we had saw. We had no difficulties in performing the audit. Jen and all our staff were very helpful in accommodating us and getting us what we needed. We had no disagreements on financial accounting, reporting, or auditing matters. So the audit, as always, went very smoothly. We have audited the annual financial report, which is prepared in accordance with the regulatory provisions provided by the ISBE, or the Illinois State Board of Education. The statements are prepared on the accrual basis of accounting, and we have issued an unmodified opinion, or a clean opinion, the best opinion you can get on your financial statements. So again, as always, a very good job on the financial accounting. As in prior years, I've handed out, or should have, a 7-page document. It's kind of a summary of the operating funds of the district. I'll briefly touch on some of the highlights for the year. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to interrupt me at any time, and I will answer those the best that I can. One thing that is not in your handout, I just wanted to point out, as part of the annual financial report, the ISB does have the schedule called the Financial Profile Summary. It's a rating system that the ISB uses standardized for all school districts. It's based on 5 different financial ratios. This year, the district score was a 3.6, which is a designation of recognition, that is the highest designation you can get. That is up from last year's score of 3.25, and that was a review designation. So the financial condition, according to the ISBE's standards, has improved from last year. On the first page of the handout, this is the condensed balance sheet for the operating funds. The ISBE considers your educational, operations and maintenance, transportation, and working cash funds to be your operating funds. On the right-hand side of the schedule, the totals for 2017. The first section, total assets. You had total assets.
Excuse me. Is this in a format that the people here can watch this as well?
It's not.
In the future, can we try to do that? Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Sure. Total assets of the district at June 30th, 2017. Were about $24.5 million, or an increase of about $1.8 million from the prior year. The first two items in that section, cash and investments, combined, you had total cash and investments of about $15.6 million at June 30, 2017. That was an increase of about $1.4 million from 2016. Next section down are your total liabilities. Total liabilities were about $8.7 million, and there was very little change, or about $8.7 million also in 2016. The last section are the total fund balances. Total fund balances were about $15.7 million at June 30, 2017, or an increase of about $1.8 million from the prior year. And of that fund balance of $15.7 million, you have about $482,000 that are considered to be reserved or restricted for specials or specific purposes. Then turn to the second page. This is the condensed statement of revenues, expenditures, and changes in fund balances, again for the core operating funds. The first section, right-hand side, total revenues. The actual revenues of your operating funds were about $39.2 million for the year into June 30, 2017, or an increase of about $831,000. Your next section down are your total expenditures. It's about $37.3 million, or a decrease of about $3.3 million in your expenditures. And that equates to about an 8% decrease in your operating fund expenditures for the year. Next section down is other financing sources and uses. You had transfers from your working cash funds to the transportation fund, and that netted about $105,000 for the year, which leaves you with excess for the year of about $1.8 million compared to a deficiency in the prior year, about $1.5 million. And again, your ending fund balance in your operating funds was about $15.7 million. If you want to then turn to the following page, condensed statement of revenues, expenditures, changes in fund balances. This is just for the educational fund of the district or the main operating fund. About halfway down the page, total revenues for the educational fund were about $34.6 million, or an increase of about $556,000 from 2016. A couple of the major items that changed up in the top section, your local sources, your real estate taxes were about $11.6 million. Those were up about $299,000. That's due strictly to your increase in your assessed valuation was up about 3% over the prior year. Your replacement taxes were about $1.5 million. Those were up $172,000 over the prior year. Next section down are your state sources. The state sources were about $16.4 million, or an increase of $300,000 from the prior year. A couple of the larger items, the first item in that section is your general state aid. That was about $15 million. That was up about $1.3 million from the prior year. All that is not an increase in your state aid. Overall, throughout all the funds of the district, the state aid increased about $600,000. There was some reallocation of general state aid in 2017 between some of the funds. So the total state aid was up only about $600,000 to the district for 2017. You had federal sources then about $4 million, and that was down approximately $100,000. Next section down are your expenditures. You had total expenditures of $33.2 million, or a decrease of about $2.4 million from 2016. A couple of the larger items, salaries. Salaries were $21.5 million. That was a decrease of about $1 million, or 4.6%. And about the fifth item down is called other objects. It's about $5.9 million. That is mainly your special education payments. That was down about $616,000 for the year. And that leaves you with excess for the year of about $1.3 million and a fund balance in your educational fund of about $10.8 million. You're going to turn then to the next page, the operations and maintenance fund, the statement of revenues, expenses, and changes in fund balance. About a quarter of the way down the page, total revenues were about $2.9 million, slightly increased about $11,000 for the year. Your total expenditures for the year are about $2 million. Those decreased about $945,000. The major item there is about halfway in the expenditure section, your capital outlay was $173,000. That was down about $725,000 for the year. That leaves you with a change or decrease, or I'm sorry, an increase in your fund balance of about $850,000. And that leaves you with a fund balance of about $2.1 million. You had your fund balance in 2015 was about $350,000. So as you can see, it had gotten very low, and over the past 2 years, the district's made a conscious effort to build that fund balance back up in your operations and maintenance fund.